Infantile spasms, I also like to call it epileptic spasms because it is, as the name suggests, infantile. It happens in infancy, which is before 1 year of life, but these can happen even beyond 1 year of life, but more common in children below 1 year of age. In addition to just the seizures, it also causes certain serious changes in the way the brain functions, which can affect a child's ability to think and process, learn, form new memories, and also causes delay in other milestones if not treated on time and aggressively. Often, the signs and symptoms may be very subtle, but typically, a child in infantile spasms, the seizures, will present with rapid episodes of flexion of the body, which is arms and legs. So they appear something like this, as if you are ab crunching. They can also appear as episodes where you are arching your back or extending your arms out, but that is relatively less common. There are other subtle episodes where the child is just bobbing his or her head down like this, and that may be very difficult to recognize. So these episodes typically last for 1 to 2 seconds, but they tend to happen in clusters. So they will happen in rapid succession in clusters of anywhere from 3 to 10, and they may happen throughout the day, but more commonly these episodes happen as soon as the child is about to sleep or first thing in the morning when the child is about to wake up. There are different treatment modalities available for infantile spasms. I would say timely recognition and aggressive treatment is the key. Depending on the cause of the infantile spasms, the treatment modalities could be different, but there are several good treatment options available for the treatment of infantile spasms. For example, steroids, which are available in oral form and injectable forms as well. There is a specific medication called vigabatrin, which is very effective in infantile spasms from a specific type of genetic condition called tuberous sclerosis. There's ketogenic diet available in infantile spasms cases that have not responded to steroids and vigabatrin. And many other medications can be used to just control other types of seizures in infantile spasms. It is a very rare disorder, epileptic disorder, and the episodes may not seem very serious as opposed to a classic convulsive, grand mal convulsive seizure, but the consequences that it can have on the developing child's brain could be very devastating. So I would say a rare but a serious disorder. The treatment for infantile spasms is extremely time sensitive because if not recognized on time and if not treated on time and aggressively, these can have serious and devastating consequences on a child's development. So for parents and a child's primary care doctors, if any doubt that these episodes could be infantile spasms, please do not hesitate to refer the child to a pediatric neurologist for further investigations and treatment.